Capricorn, and welcome to your May 2016 tarot reading. My name is Nikki, and like always, I'd like to welcome you to my channel if you're new, and remind you that this is a general reading for all Capricorns, so if you are interested in a personal reading just for yourself, you can visit my website. It is linked in the description below. Now, it's $15 per tarot reading, and I do have some other offers and deals going on there, so check those out. And I also offer palmistry if that's something you're interested in. And I also want to say that if you do not have a PayPal account, fret not, you can always make a purchase at my Etsy website, and that will also be linked in the description below. Okay. So before we begin, I'd like to point your attention to the lovely gemstones above the cards. The one to the right, that is emerald. And I'm resonating with emerald for the month of May because it is the planetary birthstone for May. Now I know I usually do the mystic or the talismanic birthstones, but I just wanted to do something a little bit different. And emerald is wonderful for rejuvenation and prosperity and things like that. Now I haven't done a video on emerald as of yet, but I do plan on doing one very soon. And if I have it done by the time this video goes up, it will also be linked in the description below. Or you could just go to my YouTube channel, and there is a playlist of all the gemstone videos, and you may find it there. Okay, so on to your reading. For the first week of May, you have the Three of Swords in reverse. Now, normally I know the Three of Swords is not a very positive card, but when it's in its reverse position, it's actually more positive than it is in its upright. So, that being said, any kind of grieving that you've been going through, any kind of heartache or anything like that, depression, or bad situation, you are coming out of in this first week. This is a period of time where you are healing, where you're putting the past behind you and you're moving forward. You're saying, you know what, I'm done with that bad situation. I'm tired of thinking about it. I'm tired of grieving over it. I'm tired of crying over it, whatever. You know, I'm just going to let it be or let go of it, and I'm moving forward. For the second week of May, you have the Star in reverse. Now, this may be a time where, you know, you lack some inspiration. The normal, your normal everyday routine or schedule may be off a little bit. Your positive thinking may be, you know, you may have a little bit of negative thoughts in the second week. You know, the Star is your muse, and she just isn't there. She's your guiding light. And you feel disconnected at this time period. Any kind of, you know, the Star normally means hope. So there's a lack of hope, a lack of faith, these type of things in the second week. Hang in there, because I'm sure she'll turn back upright. Just give her some time. With the third week of May, you have the Chariot in its upright position. Now, this is a very positive card. This is you having control over opposing forces. This is things coming against you and you not letting it. This is you having willpower and strength all combined. You are ruling over the reins. So, you know, whatever was getting to you in the second week is definitely not affecting your third week. So that's wonderful. This is a great time to start any kind of goals that you have, you know, and if you want to start a diet regimen or exercise regimen or whatever, you know, if you want to start a new project, if you want to clean out your house, get rid of the clutter, whatever it is that you're wanting to do, this is a great time to do it. This is a great time to get started, because you're definitely going to have the willpower and the devotion to whatever project it is. Now, in a literal sense, if you take this card literally, the Chariot can be talking about transportation. So you may be going somewhere in this third week, somewhere maybe your mode of transportation is something that you normally do not, you know, take, like an airplane or a boat or a motorcycle or whatever. You may be getting a new car in the third week or thinking about getting a new car. This may be something that is, you know, heavily on your mind. You may be, you know, putting the money into your car, making it better. In the last week of May, you have the Magician. Now, the Magician, he's also very similar to the Chariot. So there's something going on where you believe, where your willpower is very strong in these last 2 weeks. You're willing things to go your way, just the way you want them. Now the Magician, he's kind of neutral. He can be positive or negative depending on the situation and depending on if you're playing the Magician or not. So he can be kind of manipulative, and that could be bad or good, because like I said, the Magician is using all his resources around him to will his way, to get what he wants. And he's very good at it. So, you know, if that is you, and, you know, that just means, and I do believe it is you, because it kind of correlates with the Chariot. So, you know, these last 2 weeks, you're really able to pull the strings and make that puppet dance the way you want it to. Or make the situation go the way you want it to get what you want. If it is somebody else in your life, this could be somebody manipulating you, and it could, you know, might not be so positive. Somebody is, could be being kind of like a trickster, or saying exactly what they need to say, or doing what they need to do to get you to think or do, what they want. But like I said, I do believe it is you, because it correlates with the Chariot card, and you know, you're just getting what you want in the last 2 weeks of May, and that's a good thing. I guess it depends on what you want, but hopefully it's all good things. Okay, so that is your reading in its entirety, Capricorn. I hope that you found it helpful. If you did, please remember to push that like button and subscribe if you haven't already subscribed, because I do this every single month. And don't forget to leave a comment. I haven't got a whole lot of comments lately, and maybe it's because I haven't mentioned it in some of my previous videos, but leave a comment. Let me know how the cards correlated with, you know, what happened in your month. I'd love to hear about it. And I will look forward to talking to you all next month. Bye-bye.